As we mentioned, Southpaws are being celebrated the world over this weekend. Our legendary lefty, Rita Braver, takes a closer look at life on the other hand.
This could be any gift and gadget shop.
There's scissors, notebooks, and pens.
But these items and scores of other products in this store are specifically designed for left-handed people. Take this pastry server.
The sharp cutting edge is on the left side.
So the correct side, we like to say.
You may recall the leftorium from The Simpsons.
Wow, what an icebreaker.
Left-handed ledges. Now I can ride all the way to the edge.
But lefties in San Francisco is the real thing.
So neat.
Opened by Margaret Majua in 2008. And guess what?
You are not a lefty.
No, I can't even fake it. I'm terrible with my left hand.
No surprise. Lefties, including your faithful correspondent, make up only an estimated 10% of the world's population. And Majua understands that we sometimes feel, well, left out.
So some of your best friends are left-handed, I know that.
Of course, we lefties do have greatness in our ranks. Artists. Actors. Musicians. Techies. And 8 of 45 presidents, including President Bill Clinton.
We seem to be overrepresented in certain fields. And maybe we're politics, safe-cracking, I don't know.
Has it ever impeded you?
No, I don't think it's ever impeded me. When I started studying the way the brain functions, it made me wonder whether it really was a sign of being a little more creative and non-rational in the way you think. And I have no conclusions on it.
About yourself?
No, I don't.
So there has been this myth that lefties are more creative.
Oh, let's kill it. Together, here and now, let's just
But there is some research that shows that left-handed people organize thoughts in a different way and tasks in a different way.
Absolutely. And that is really mysterious.
Author and journalist David Wallman was so intrigued by the mysteries and myths surrounding left-handers like him that he spent a year traveling the world to write a book about the hand often associated with the devil. The very word left comes from the Old English lift, meaning weak or worthless.
The Latin word for left is sinister, so
that's
just
really
get that right out on the
right.
Table.
Gauche in French, gauche? Which also means kind of crude and
right.
Undesirable.
You should certainly not be eating with the left hand in countries where you don't have utensils.
Why is that?
Well, you know, it's not the cleanest dinner table talk, but the answer to that is that in poorer parts of the world, people are trying to keep separate which hand they eat with and which hand they clean themselves with.
You mean after using the bathroom, so to speak?
Exactly.
And older Americans may still remember when writing with the left hand was a no-no.
There were school teachers who were trying to whack this behavior out of them, and in other parts of the world, punishments were very severe for following what is just a natural tendency.
Lefties know all the jibes, the left-handed compliment, and more recently, swipe left for reject. And there's always having two left feet. Still, many lefties are great athletes, from quarterbacks to tennis players.
In baseball, I think it definitely is a good thing.
Sean Doolittle is not out in left field. He's one in a long line of famous Southpaw pitchers. In 2019, he was the closer, helping the Washington Nationals win Game 1 of the World Series.
I got brought in the 8th inning when they had a left-handed hitter up. And so I got the final out of the 8th inning, and I finished the 9th inning, and we got the win.
Into left center field, Robles is there, and the Nationals take Game 1.
One of the advantages seems to be that lefty pitchers are good not just at getting left-handed batters out, but also right-handed batters, because
righties aren't used to facing people like you so much.
Right, it's just a different look because in baseball there are much fewer left-handed pitchers, so the ball's coming in on a different angle.
But like most human beings, left or right-handed, Doolittle is also a bit ambidextrous.
I play golf right-handed, I kick with my right foot, I'm pretty good with scissors.
Which hand do you bat with?
I just realized this. I swing a bat lefty, but I swing a golf club righty. That's pretty weird.
So much is weird about being left-handed. Scientists know it's at least partially genetic, but they've never been able to figure out exactly how it's passed on. Now, a recent study by scientists at the University of Oxford using genetic data from some 400,000 United Kingdom residents has revealed important new information. Dr. Akira Weiberg.
We compared the differences in DNA sequence between a very large group of left-handers and a large group of right-handers. And what that showed was that there were four regions in the genome where the two groups were significantly different on average.
Professor Gwen Duo says the study found some very preliminary connections between handedness and development of certain diseases.
The proportion is ever so slightly higher for schizophrenia in left-handed people. And that's exactly the opposite in Parkinson's disease. So if you are left-handed, you've got a slightly lesser risk of developing Parkinson's disease. But again, we are talking about very, very small effects.
Still, Professor Dominic Furness says the discovery could yield important information on devising new treatments.
What are the important structures within the brain that are not working properly in these diseases? Why are they not working properly at a very fundamental level?
The study also found some differences between left and right-handers in the brain's white matter, the material through which messages pass to the central nervous system.
So that's really connecting the different parts of your brain that are enabling language.
The study does say that your findings raise the possibility that left-handed people have an advantage when it comes to performing verbal tasks.
This is really a theory that we have that requires scientific testing, I would say.
Sometimes, like, I feel a little bit different than everyone else.
Youth psychologist Charlotte Resnick, a lefty herself, welcomes the idea of more scientific research.
It's helpful to educate others who are right-handed, because it's really a little tough to be left-handed in a right-handed world sometimes.
But the young lefty she introduced us to seemed to take it all in stride.
I don't pay attention to that.
Even the ink stains.
That's the only bad thing I've noticed about being lefty is that you always get it on your hand. It's very annoying.
Still,
it's something that you should be proud of and even though you're different.
What would you say to parents who think, oh gosh, my child would just do better because the world is right-handed?
Hey! No!
And what would lefty expert David Wallman do? If somebody came to you and said, okay, I can magically make you right-handed like everybody else.
Me?
What would you say?
I would say, are you out of your mind?
Right.
No, never. No, no, and no.
Me either.
Right? Cheers to lefties.
Cheers to lefties.